Daily morning prayer. Saturday, July 20th, 2024. The hour is coming and is now here, when the true worshippers will worship the Father in spirit and truth, for the Father seeketh such people to worship. Let us humbly confess our sins, Almighty God. Almighty and most merciful Father, we have erred and strayed from your ways of lost sheep. We have followed too much the devices and desires of our own hearts. We have offended against your holy laws. We have left undone those things which we ought to have done, and we have done those things which we ought not to have done, and apart from your grace, there is no health in us. O Lord, have mercy upon us. Spare all those who confess your faults. Restore all those who are penitent, according to your promises declared to all people in Christ Jesus our Lord. And grant, O most merciful Father, for his sake, that we may now live a godly, righteous, and sober life, to the glory of your holy name. Amen. Grant to your faithful people, merciful Lord, pardon and peace, that we may be cleansed from all our sins and serve you with a quiet mind, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. O Lord, open our lips, and our mouths shall proclaim your praise. O God, make speed to save us. O Lord, make haste to help us. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Praise the Lord. The Lord's name be praised. The mercy of the Lord is everlasting. O come, let us adore him. O be joyful in the Lord, all you lands. Serve the Lord with gladness, and come before his presence with a song. Be assured that the Lord, he is God. It is he that has made us, and not we ourselves. We are his people and the sheep of his pasture. O go your way into his gates with thanksgiving, and into his courts with praise. Be thankful unto him, and speak good of his name. For the Lord is gracious, his mercy is everlasting, and his truth endures from generation to generation. The mercy of the Lord is everlasting. O come, let us adore him. Hear my prayer, O Lord, and let my cry come unto you. Hide not your face from me in the time of my trouble. Incline your ear to me when I call. O hear me, and very soon. My days are consumed like smoke, and my bones are burnt up as in a furnace. My heart is smitten and withered like grass, so that I forget to eat my bread. Because of the voice of my groaning, my bones will scarcely cleave to my flesh. I have become like an owl in the wilderness, and like a screech owl among the ruins. I am solitary and like speechless because of my groaning. I am like a sparrow that sits alone upon the housetop. My enemies revile me all day long, and those who are enraged against me conspire to do me hurt. For I have eaten ashes as if they were bread, and mingled my drink with weeping because of your indignation and wrath. For you have taken me up and cast me down. My days are gone like a shadow, and I am withered like grass. But you, O Lord, shall endure forever in your remembrance throughout all generations. You shall arise and have mercy upon Zion, for it is time for you to have mercy upon her. Indeed, the time has come. For your servants love her very stones, and are moved to pity to see her in the dust. The nations shall fear your name, O Lord, and all the kings of the earth your majesty. When the Lord shall build up Zion, and when his glory shall appear, when he returns to the prayer of the destitute, and despises not their plea, this shall be written for those that come after, and a people that shall yet be born shall praise the Lord. For he has looked down from his sanctuary and from the heavens. The Lord has beheld the earth, that he might hear the groanings of those who are in captivity, and deliver those who are condemned to die, that they may declare the name of the Lord in Zion, and his praises in Jerusalem, when the peoples are gathered together, and the kingdoms also to serve the Lord. He brought down my strength before my time, and shortened my days. But I said, O my God, take me not away in the midst of my days, for your years endure throughout all generations. You, Lord, in the beginning laid the foundation of the earth and the heavens are the work of your hands. They shall perish, but you shall endure. It all shall well out as does a garment, and as a garment you shall change them, and they shall be changed, but you are the same, and your years shall not fail. The children of your servants shall continue, and your seed shall stand fast in your sight. Praise the Lord, O my soul. Praise the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits. Who forgives all your sin and heals all your infirmities, who saves your life from the pit and crowns you with mercy and loving kindness, who satisfies you with good things and renewing your youth like an eagle's. The Lord executes righteousness and judgment for all those who are oppressed with wrong. He showed his ways to Moses, his works to the children of men. The Lord is full of compassion and mercy, long-suffering and of great goodness. He will not always chide us, neither will he keep his anger forever. He has not dealt with us according to our sins, nor rewarded us according to our wickedness. For as the heavens are high above the earth, so great is his mercy also toward those who fear him. As far as the east is from the west, so far has he set our sins from us. As a father pities his own children, so is the Lord merciful to those who fear him. For he knows whereof we are made. He remembers that we are but dust. The days of man are as grass. He flourishes as a flower of the field. For as soon as the wind goes over it, it is gone, and its place shall know it no more. But the merciful goodness of the Lord endures forever and ever upon those who fear him, and his righteousness upon children's children, even upon those who keep his covenant and think upon his commandments to do them. The Lord has prepared his throne in heaven, and his kingdom rules over all. Oh, praise the Lord, you angels of his, you that excel in strength, you that fulfill his commandment and hearken unto the voice of his words. Oh, praise the Lord, all you his hosts, you servants of his that do his pleasure. Oh, speak good of the Lord, all you works of his, in all places of his dominion. Praise the Lord, O my soul. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
A reading from St. Paul's second epistle to the Corinthians, beginning with the second chapter, the 12th verse. Now when I came to Troas for the gospel of Christ, and when a door was opened for me in the Lord, I had no rest for my spirit, not finding Titus, my brother, but saying goodbye to them, I went on to Macedonia. But thanks be to God, who always leads us in triumph in Christ, and through us reveals the fragrance of the knowledge of him in every place. For we are a fragrance of Christ to God among those who are being saved and among those who are perishing. To the one, an aroma from death to death. To the other, an aroma from life to life. And who is adequate for these things? For we are not like the many peddling the word of God, but as from sincerity, but as from God, we speak in Christ in the sight of God. Are we beginning to commend ourselves again, or do we need for as some letters of commendation to you or from you? You are our letter, written in our hearts, known and read by all people, revealing ourselves that you are a letter of Christ delivered by us, written not with ink, but with the Spirit of the living God, not on tablets of stone, but on tablets of human hearts. Such is the confidence we have toward God through Christ. Not that we are adequate in ourselves so as to consider anything as having come from ourselves, but our adequacy is from God, who also made us adequate as servants of a new covenant, not of the letter, but of the Spirit, for the letter kills, but the Spirit gives life. But if the ministry of death, engraved in letters of stone, came with glory so that the sons of Israel could not look intently at the face of Moses because of the glory of his face, fading as it was. How will the ministry of the Spirit fail to be even more with glory? For if the ministry of condemnation has glory, much more does the ministry of righteousness excel in glory. For indeed we had glory in this case has no glory. For indeed what had glory in this case has no glory, because the glory thus surpasses it. For if that which fades away was with glory, much more that which remains is in glory. Therefore, having such a hope, we use great boldness in our speech, and we are not like Moses, who used to put a veil over his face so that the sons of Israel would not stare at the end of what was fading away. But their minds were hardened, for until this very day at the reading of the Old Covenant, the same veil remains unlifted because it is removed in Christ. But to this day, whenever Moses is read, a veil lies over their hearts. But whenever someone turns to the Lord, the veil is taken away. Now the Lord is the Spirit, and where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is freedom. But we all, with unveiled faces, looking as in a mirror at the glory of the Lord, are being transformed into the same image from glory to glory, just as from the Lord, the Spirit. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. O ruler of the universe, Lord God, great deeds are they that you have done, surpassing human understanding. Your ways are ways of righteousness and truth, O King of all the ages. Who can fail to do homage, Lord, and sing the praises of your name? For you only are the Holy One. All nations will draw near and fall down before you, because your just and holy works have been revealed. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and a life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you and with your spirit. Let us pray. Lord, have mercy upon us. Christ, have mercy upon us. Lord, have mercy upon us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. O Lord, show your mercy upon us and grant us your salvation. O Lord, guide those who govern us and lead us in the way of justice and truth. Clothe your ministers with righteousness and let your people sing with joy. O Lord, save your people and bless your inheritance. Give peace in our time, O Lord, and defend us by your mighty power. Let not the needy, O Lord, be forgotten, nor the hope of the poor be taken away. Create in us clean hearts, O God, and take not your Holy Spirit from us. Let your merciful ears, O Lord, be open to the prayers of your humble servants, and that we may receive what we ask. Teach us by your Holy Spirit to ask only those things that are pleasing to you. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who with you and the same Spirit lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. Almighty God, who after the creation of the world rested from all your works and sanctified a day of rest for all your creatures, grant that we, putting away all earthly anxieties, may be duly prepared for the service of your sanctuary, and that our rest here upon earth may be a preparation for the eternal rest promised to your people in heaven. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Lord Jesus Christ, you stretched out your arms of love on the hardwood of the cross that everyone might come within the reach of your saving embrace. So clothe us in your spirit that we, reaching forth our hands in love, may bring those who do not know you to the knowledge and love of you for the honor of your name. Amen. Almighty God, Father of all mercies, we, your unworthy servants, give you humble thanks for all your goodness and loving kindness to us and to all whom you have made. We bless you for our creation, preservation, and all the blessings of this life, but above all, for your immeasurable love and the redemption of the world by our Lord Jesus Christ, for the means of grace and for the hope of glory. And we pray, give us such an awareness of your mercies that with truly thankful hearts we may show forth your praise, not only with our lips, but in our lives, by giving up ourselves to your service, by walking before you in holiness and righteousness all our days. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be honor and glory throughout all ages. Amen. Almighty God, you have given us grace at this time with one accord to make our common supplications to you, and you have promised through your well-beloved Son that when two or three are gathered together in his name, you will grant their requests. Fulfill now, Lord, our desires and petitions as may be best for us, granting us in this world knowledge of your truth and in the age to come, life everlasting. Amen. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all evermore. Amen.